Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, my name is Marta or Marta, however you wanna say it. Today we have a fun video. Has anyone else been buying really weird things on Instagram during quarantine? Just me, because I know for a fact that businesses have cranked up their advertisements, because I'll be going through stories and every like third click is an ad. Okay, so then I decided, you know what, some of these things are really random, some of them are weird, so I'm gonna make a video where I kind of just buy whatever ad Instagram throws at me, and this is that video. So without further ado, let's start with the first thing that arrived to me. I'm just gonna go in order of things that are arriving. Some of them take a really long time. I'm actually sitting here still waiting for another item to ship to me, so hopefully that comes in sooner than later. But yeah, let's jump right into it. Hi everyone, so I have a few of the items. These are the items that arrived first, so let's get moving. Excuse my appearance, but I am going to be reviewing foundation, so I'm coming at you with a bare face. First thing that I've had for the longest are the Gali gummies. I actually applied for their influencer program, so I do have a discount code for you guys. I am obsessed with these. Like, I've already had two today, so I'm not gonna have another one. But let me just show you. These apple cider gummies are so stinking good. It's like that perfect thing to just eat in the morning to wake up your taste buds. And if you guys like intermittent fasting, it can help you go longer not eating, because you won't have cravings. So combining this and working out every day and eating home-cooked meals, I've gotten in better shape while being quarantined. So I recommend these. This is a 60-piece pack, so a month, you know. And they're super cheap, so this is a bang for your buck. So thank you, Instagram, for recommending these. I'm obsessed. Next, I don't even, like, look at this. What is this? Like, okay, taking it out of the box. So this is the Biosense products that I decided to get from the Instagram ad. So this actually came with a free tea tree cleansing gel. I'm gonna give this to my boyfriend because he struggles with acne, and I know tea tree oil is great for that, so I'm gonna give that to him. But this is the actual product that I bought. So the Gali gummies got to me in like a week and a half. These ones took 2 weeks. This is the vegan lip balm. I'm so excited about that because my lips are disgusting. My lips, I destroy them. Ooh. Ooh, I can't wait to smell this. Whoa. My AC just turned on and it's screaming loud, so I just ran and turned the AC off. Anyway, so this is the vegan lip balm. Nourishes and visibly plumps the lips. Are you kidding? Because I have no upper lip, so if it could plump my lip, that would be fantastic. It is a teeny tiny amount. Oh my goodness. I can't even fit my finger in it. Doesn't come with a scoop or anything, so you have to just use your hand. I'm like digging into it. It's getting in my nail, so I kind of wish I had a scooper, but. Is it plumping my lip? Let's just watch. I don't think it's plumping it. The goal is that this stays on my lips before I can like eat it off my lips and then start picking my lips. This is a squalene vitamin C rose oil, facial oil for visibly brighter and firmer skin. It's a little dropper. Oh, that just smells like roses, straight up. I'm just gonna do a couple little drops. It's a little more drippy than my Rejuvenique oil. Oh, but then when I rub it, it's rubbing really like thin. Oh, I smell literally like fresh roses. Vitamin C is really good for your skin. And I actually just ran out of my vitamin C serum, so. Okay guys, my phone is close to death. It has 10% battery, even though I charged it for like 2 hours. didn't work, clearly. So it basically says try the product for 14 days and then, yeah, so it gives you instructions. So it says apply 2 pumps onto your entire face, blend out with a brush or sponge, wait 5 minutes for it to set before checking the shade. Don't match to your neck or wrist because they are a different color than your face. Finish your face with a concealer. I matched it to my shoulder that when I got it, so it's a little bit dark. But anyway, this is what it comes like. Because look, it's a little dark, like for my face. So I matched it to my shoulder. I don't know, guys, but it is full size. So yeah, I saw so many advertisements for this. I have a brush and I have a beauty sponge. So it says 2 pumps. 1, 2. Whoa, that's pretty spot on. Does that not look like spot on? Okay, I don't know, we'll see. It says that 2 pumps should cover my whole face. Oh, that's a really nice finish. It's like a, I think I wanted it to look natural. They asked me if I wanted a full coverage, a matte look, or a wet look, and I picked natural. So, I'm trying to see like at a distance if it's matching. I think it is. I need another little squirty for my forehead. It's actually really good. I mean, it's matching my shoulder. Sorry, guys. It's matching my shoulder, maybe like a little bit lighter than my shoulder, but my chest is super pale right now. But it's also not looking orangey. Like normally when I get foundation for my skin type, it looks orange. Ignore my awful lip. But look at this. It's really similar to my skin type. Wow. This just work? Did this just like, this is literally the color of my skin. Oh my goodness. Okay, now it says to wait some time to see it like settle. But use this. I do wanna finish my makeup. So let me like finish my face and then show you guys what it looks like. Okay guys, so I finished up my makeup. I did just have a sandwich, so my lipstick's kind of off a little bit. But I am so impressed. Like I feel like I look like I don't have a lot of foundation on, but it also, like, it's because it matches me. Like, I mean, naturally your neck is gonna be lighter because that's just how it is, but in my hands. But if we take out the neck and the hands, if you look at, you know, my chest and my face, like it all matches together. And then I was downstairs in my kitchen with natural lighting on me and it really looked nice. Overall, I am super, super impressed, and I'm definitely keeping this bad boy because I don't have any other foundation that matches me. So, keeping this one, great idea. And that's it for now, so I'll see you when the rest of the stuff arrives. All right, guys, today, well, actually a few days ago, my lash lift kit came in. I don't know if you guys have seen this advertisement where it shows the girl with, like, goop on her eye, and then it perms the lashes, but I see it all the time on Instagram, so I decided to purchase it. I have the kit here. I didn't even look up videos, reviews. I didn't want to do anything because I just wanted to try it myself. And then now that I've had it here, I did look up some videos and I didn't see anyone getting any crazy reactions to it. I don't have sensitive skin in general, so I think I'm gonna be fine, but we shall watch and see. So this is what it comes with. It comes with like perm glue, nutrition, fixation, cleansing, a cleaning tool, the lift pads, and I don't even know what this is. False lash glue. So it gives you a false lash glue. The reason I'm doing this is because I started using a lash serum, okay? I used the Modern Nature Lash Serum and I didn't expect it to work, but holy moly, my lashes are so long right now. Obviously they aren't curled or anything. I don't have makeup on, but they are so long and full. but they stand out like this. And I'm like, I want them to curl. So I'm going to be trying this. Like, here we go. I'm watching a video. I don't know what I'm doing. So it has the directions on the back. Step one, use the cleanser four to remove oil, dust, and makeup and residue on your eyes. Okay, tool. What is this? What is these pieces of plastic? How do I cleanse tool? This is plastic. Okay, can you guys see that it has teeth, like a little mini comb, and that's what you use? Oh, this is so cool. Okay, so I'm gonna get the cleansing stuff. This one, itty bitty one, says cleanse. Or I guess I can just put it inside. There we go. Is that wet? Oh, now that's wet. That's wet for sure. If you are weird about things being close to your eye, this is gonna be a rough one for you. I'm gonna say those are clean because I don't wanna do that anymore. Next step, we're gonna get the lift pads. There's different sizes in here, looks like, so I guess I just have to find one that fits my lash size. Small, medium. They all have sizes. They have sizes written in the top part. I don't know if you guys can see right there. It says small, medium. Okay, so then you're gonna take this lash glue and you're gonna use it to put onto the flat part of this eye thing. It has like a nice little wand. And so you'll just paint it. This is kind of like eyelash glue. This feels so weird. All right, guys, we got the second one going on. How am I supposed to do this when I can't even open my eyeballs? This is so annoying. Anyway, you're gonna get the perm solution. Use the perm solution one on the eyelashes, then cover it with plastic wrap. Did you get your saran wrap? So you're gonna get your perm solution and then you're gonna get a Q-tip. Perm solution. I'm just gonna dunk my Q-tip in it. And here we go. That smells awful. But I know that that's normal for perm stuff. How is it supposed to stick? Oh shit, I forgot something. I forgot I'm supposed to put glue on my lashes. Where is the lash glue? Where's the lash glue? We were not done with the lash glue. We're supposed to glue the lashes. Oh, I think I might have ruined it. Like, look how long my lashes are, you guys. If they were curled, they'd be so cute. I've been doing this forever. My lashes won't stay up. A hair dryer was not listed as one of the things that you needed. Quickly, now I'm gonna get the perm solution. Now you take the perm solution and you start to wipe it onto the lashes, like so. It smells awful, like a hard water well, but that's just what you get, I guess. How much perm solution do I put? Am I supposed to like soak it until it sticks to the, because every time I'm doing this, I'm changing the shape of what it gets stuck in. I'm just gonna like hold it as much as I can. I got it in my eye. Is this okay? Is this allowed? Is it allowed in your eye? Am I gonna go blind? Is this allowed in your eyeballs? Does anybody know? God, my eyes are really burning now. Do tears impact the perm? Because I'm definitely crying. Oh, I need a clean Q-tip and go in for the kill, Marta. Suck it up. I forgot about the plastic wrap, you guys. Just put that on there and shape the lashes the way you want. Oh God. Oh my goodness. What do I do for 10 minutes with my eyes closed? Listen to a podcast. I'll be right back. I don't know where the camera is. So I was gonna read the directions on what's next, but I can't. I'm just gonna make a little window. Oh, there we go. Okay. Remove the lotion with the Y brush and apply the fixing agent onto your lashes. Okay, how does this remove the lotion? All right, well, let's see. I cried a lot under there. guys, look at how much I cried. Look at how much I cried. Okay, next you get your Y brush and, oh God, none of this is like stuck anymore. Fixing solution. Dip your Q-tip into it, okay? And then you're gonna wipe it onto the lashes. Hopefully this does the trick. Okay, this is actually starting to work. This is actually moving them. Could I have just used this the whole time? All right, do you guys see? I look repulsive, but do you guys see how it's starting to work? I just think the placement was so bad on this one. Like, just look at the difference of how much these are curling. I'm gonna actually cut this. I think that's what I should have done in the first place. You see that? You see that? That looks much better. We back at it again with the plastic wrap. Another 10 minutes. Use the cleanser number 4 to remove all residue with the Y brush. Y brush ain't gonna do ish. Okay, I'm gonna use a Q-tip. Use nutrition lotion to nourish your lashes. Oh, that's nice. Nutritional yeast. Oh my God, you guys. I started this video so sane and now I'm losing my mind. We back and we ready to attack. Now we're gonna remove. No! I literally have 3 lashes curled. One of my lashes over here is curling to the left. It's just curling to the left. Now you're gonna get the nutrition. This little thing right here, we're gonna dip into the nutrition. That smells good. That smells like rose water. And then it says, no, that's it. That's all you do. This is it. This is the end. This is the final look. I definitely think that it finally did curl them, but the issue is that I guess I should have used a flatter one of these so I could really curl them, because the one I had was a little bit round and so my lashes weren't long enough to make it all the way up, so they would be more curled at this point. This one, these two bees in the middle are hella curled, when in reality, I wanted these end pieces curled and they're not curled at all. Look at all the makeup that was removed when, you know, by my tears. So, final thoughts on this bad boy. As you know, annoying as it was, I know that this will work if you do it correctly. The first time I used magnetic lashes, the first time I did my own eyelash extensions, like anything that I did the first time, it wasn't good. Okay, it takes practice. But I think that if you have long lashes, like I use a lash serum, so my lashes are really long, but you don't want to wear mascara, then you could do this to go on a tropical vacation. But I'm not going on a tropical vacation because I can't go anywhere, but I think this would work. So anyway, I'm fine. Just try not to get in your eye, because it scared me, I think, more than hurt me. It scared me, and so I was just alarmed. Anyway, this took up majority of this video, didn't it? I mean, it's okay. I'm gonna try again another time. All right, thank you. On to the next. Hey guys, we back. Okay guys, finally, the final thing. Okay, I'm gonna be honest, there is one more thing that has not arrived and I'm just not waiting anymore because I really wanna put this video up for you guys. But, so, the last thing is Glamnetics. Look at this cool packaging, you guys. So, Glamnetics, here was the ad that I saw, Glamnetics. I've seen so many ads, it's just been haunting me. Non-stop ads all the time. I don't know about you guys, but I have. So basically what it is a liner that is magnetic, has maybe little magnetic particles in it, which I don't know how safe that is, considering when I wash my face, the magnet is probably gonna get into my eye, which can't be good. I don't know, we'll see. And the lashes that it comes with. So before I jump into this really quickly, you guys, I just wanted to show you guys my permed lashes. I did not put mascara on because I'm not sure if you are supposed to with this, but I wanted to show you that it like really did work. So you can see the middle lash is still, oh my goodness. Okay, so curling the lashes definitely worked. I have such long lashes now. All right, anyway, now let's review Glamnetics. So let that dry. So the packaging is galaxy. It's so, so cute. Not a tapered end, kind of just like a flat out. It's gonna be tough. That smells interesting. It smells like paint. It smells like paint a little bit. So we have that. And then I got a kit that came with two, or did I buy these separate? I don't really know. All I know is I have two separate lash types. So this first one is called Live-In, I believe. And these ones really look natural. They're just about length. So rather than fullness, these are really about length. And then the second ones, I got a more dramatic one that are about, you know, density. So because I'm not wearing a ton of makeup today, we're just gonna do the length ones because you guys know I'm just like obsessed with having long lashes. But these don't look much longer than my current lashes. But we're still gonna do it. So, okay, so we're gonna use those. Okay, so the band is thick and covered with little magnets. I have to see if this is like a good size for me, or if I should cut one of the magnets off. I think I need to cut, yeah. I'm gonna go to the edge. Where's my scissors? I'm gonna go to the edge of the magnet and just cut one of them. Okay, so I cut like a good deal off. Yes, these are children's scissors. That's the issue with having these lashes curled now. Normally I make my eyeliner really thin in the inside, but I'm trying to make it thicker. I'm gonna be amazed if this works. Amazed. If this sticks right to the thing, I'm gonna be shook. Okay, just shook. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa. Okay, okay, okay. So, it gripped. Whoa, okay, it's really on there. It is really on there. There is no adjusting that. I mean, it did, like, it gripped right on there. Okay, we're gonna stop there. Oh my god, that was so bad. Okay, the inner, look at that. This is so bad, this is so bad. The inner one will not lock on. I don't know why, it's slipping around. Man, at this point, I'm thinking the eyelash perming was more worth it because my lashes were already curled. I didn't even need these lashes at this point, which I know you're probably like, why did you perm your lashes if you were gonna get magnetic lashes? Because of Instagram, it told me to buy both. And they arrived in the same week. It feels so sticky. Like, let me see how easy it is to take them off. That was really easy. So it's really easy to take them off. And then you can just, that's the left eye, you can just put them right back in the case. So that's good, keep the case, okay? I think if it's done correctly, again, just like the lash perming, it takes some time. I kind of prefer my Ardell Magnetic Wispies. So I have my makeup remover balm. You guys know I switched from makeup wipes to a balm, and I just have a little towel here. And I'm gonna get some of the balm. Let's see if it comes off my eyeballs. Magnetic stuff. Oh, this is what happens when you use a makeup balm. Alright guys, we're gonna do some final thoughts. I just took all that liner off and just put my mascara back on because I'm kind of obsessed with the permed lashes. So the last item that I did order that has still not arrived in time was the Care of Daily Vitamins. I don't take any daily vitamins and I want to start. So I really liked that when I took this quiz, you know, it took note of the fact that I can't fall asleep at night and I wake up really tired. I get anxiety. What else did I say? That I don't eat a lot of fruits. It asked me what state I'm in, so it could tell if I was like what altitude I was, and because I'm like above a certain altitude, it recommended something for my bones. Like this was like vitamin D, magnesium, cranberry, and then some crazy plant, some type of Indian plant that's supposed to help me. So anyway, that's coming. So I'll have those daily facts, but they did not arrive, and I really want to put this video up for you guys. So hey guys, so literally the day right after I filmed that, the package arrived from Care Of. So this is what they look like, and inside there's individual packs of, I'm trying to look at the thing. And it says, hi Marta, and it tells me a little today challenge. Start reading a new book today. If you usually read fiction, try nonfiction and vice versa. It's pretty interesting. But you can see it's clear, and you can see all the vitamins that they recommended for me. I've been taking them for like 5 days now, and I'm not good at taking pills, but I'm doing okay for now. Okay, so I think that it's cute, and they gave me enough for a month, so I'm gonna have to keep buying more, but we'll see if I feel any different taking them. But I just wanted you guys to know that they did finally arrive. It only took 2 months of ordering and them to arrive, but they did arrive.
Overall, I guess recapping all the different Instagram ads that were marketed to me, they were marketed to me correctly. That is, I am their target audience, so it was correct. But do you need these items? No. No one needs any of these. You don't absolutely need them. The big thing that I'm like, why the heck did I buy it, was the lip moisturizer, and then it came with this tea tree cleanser with the rose oil. Like, you don't need that. You don't need it. I got it. I don't even know why. So you don't need that. You don't need these magnetic glamnetic lashes. You don't have to perm your lashes, but it is something fun to do right now while we are stuck at home. I love the next day how they look. Like, again, my makeup's a little messed up because but these are like my real lashes. I think they look pretty freaking good, but my makeup is ferocious right now because I was digging in there. What else did we do? The foundation. It was fun, it matched my skin, but I didn't really love the finish of it. It's so hard to get foundation online. I need to like go into Sephora, try the foundation, then go home. You know, they'd give you a little makeover or give you a little sample of it, see how it lays after a few hours, because the Il Makiage one gets very greasy on me. I noticed that. So yeah, this was fun. This was a lot of fun. No, but it was, and I really was glad that I was able to do this for you guys, and it made me realize how many ads are being thrown at us right now as we are tapping through Instagram. So just be careful. Don't try to spend all your money, because you'll realize you really didn't need a lot of this stuff, but yeah. Okay, guys, I love you so much. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for your patience with my uploading, and I really hope that you guys liked this video, because it was fun filming it. I had to wait a while for things, but it was fun filming. All right, guys, I'll see you next time. Bye.